here today. The Chartwell Apiary, this is where we brought those two big boxes from Clip River. We're going to work on the one box tonight, the biggest one. Just worried because the bottom was broken. We've had a few storms recently. I don't want those beeves to fall over. So we're going to level them out properly. We're going to go through that box, just have a look and see what's in there. Maybe we get some honey tonight. There's two brood boxes on there, so I can only expect that this colony is going to be quite big. This is our first inspection on these boxes because they were donated to us. We have no idea if they're super aggressive and we don't know how big they are. We're going to find out now.
I feel that Ceylon's comb's quite old on there. I'm seeing capped honey, I think, at the top through here. Side door.
Yeah, yeah, this one's going to pull that. So we'll take this one out. Just dust it off. A little bit of honey.
A little bit of honey, not a square.
You can leave that one on for a while.
Okay. How's this one looking?
Broke. Yeah. It seems there was no bottom to that one, but that is absolutely filled with honey.
I think the bottom might be in there, but yeah,
in there it is. Yeah. We're gonna have to clean off the top of.
If you know, there was no bottom to that frame.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Okay, this next one we can take as well.
It doesn't seem to be capped or anything.
Not?
No.
Capped on my side.
Oh no, it is a little bit shallow. It's a bit stuck on the side, yeah.
You know what we need to do? We need to crack it. Let's crack it, yeah? As we said, this hive hasn't been opened for 3 years. So it's got two brood boxes and two supers on. And we're pulling some good honey, some good capped honey off it.
All these pieces are just so stuck.
Yeah, well, that's what happens when you leave a hive for so long, is the bees really, really stick everything together. And this one doesn't look too capped on this side either.
It's very capped on this side. It might be like the last one where it's not capped on one side. But this one has a lot of normal honey. But
you want to leave that one behind then?
Do you want to?
Yeah, I think leave that one in. So far the bees are being really kind to us. They're not attacking right now. We haven't got down into the brood box. So I suspect we might have a different set of circumstances once we get down there. But everything's going quite well now at the moment. Just the only struggles fighting the propolis that's glued the frames into place. Yeah, that one's lekker this side.
Well, that's very nice. These guys are making some fantastic bits of honey.
You might wonder why we're working at night. We didn't know what was in this box. And so we decided to do this evening on the basis that the bees can get pretty aggressive during the day. At night we can control them a lot easier with light, smoke. So what we're doing here is we're putting some of our old honeycomb from one of our previous harvests in so that the bees don't have to do too much work.
That's cool.
Nice surprise there. First super right at the top of this hive, producing some good honey. Yeah, there we go. We're into the second super on this big hive that we brought from Henley and Clip. I think I'm expecting that we'll probably find a bit more cat's honey in this because we were quite fortunate with the top. Yeah, so let's see if we can get one of these frames out. How many frames we've got in here as well? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You also did 9 frames in this one. Yeah, he's got a 9 frame spacer in this, so that's fine. See the silver thing?
Yeah.
The other one, he didn't seem to have a 9 frame spacer though, hey? Did you see the silver thing on it?
He didn't.
Let's just crack the bottom as well.
Okay. Above or below?
Above the phoenix leader.
Above, okay.
This one is stuck, eh?
Already scraped off my side here.
Oh, there you go.
It's a nice looking piece.
Okay, this side's loose.
This side's loose.
Okay, this is a
nice comb on this side.
Yeah, a new piece of comb. But he didn't put any wax sheets in or anything, so.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fine. We'll leave this one for them.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, that's it, eh? Now we're getting into the brood.
Sure, okay.
3 years of build up here. On top of these frames that was just under the phoenix cluder this gentleman had on this hive. I'm just cleaning this so that we can get these frames out of the box. Have a look at them and see what's on them. You know, there could quite possibly be honey on these. These are brood frames in a brood box that was just below the phoenix cluder. Might possibly be honey on these as well. How many frames has he got here now as well? Just count them.
Nine again. They're at quite an angle over here.
Yeah. Nine is not great on a brood box.
Okay, where do you want to start?
Probably that's around the skew frame there.
This one, this one.
Which one you want to do, this one, this one?
I'm wondering. It's going to be a pain because they're very much joined together.
I see what you're saying. It's a bit of a mess, eh? Okay, wait.
No, it's tearing, it's tearing. I'm wondering. Man.
These frames are stuck in there, eh?
Just trying to separate these from the pieces below. Oh wow.
That's it.
I think that's all honey.
Yeah, there's a massive frame of honey.
Yeah, all of these seem to be just filled of honey. This next one also.
Okay, then just move it across and we'll just take this whole thing off. We'll take it with our thumb.
Yeah.
These drone cells, there's a lot of nectar in it. Yes, it's a bad frame, man. Check out the bolt.
Oh geez, yeah, I know.
So this comb is like actually such a mess in there. It's built across and
through, and it's actually a disaster.
Frames are broken.
Okay.
This is not well maintained, this part.
How many frames in this one? 9 as well?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, yeah, and this one's new. The question is, do you want to open all this up and inspect and see?
I don't want to break everything, that's the thing.
Yeah, no, neither do I. So I'm not actually thinking we should open this.
The box is fine, hey, it's the floor that's a problem. Can we take this box off that floor?
Maybe. Yeah, let's just probably try to do that. Nailed in, yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, then how are we gonna do this?
Apparently so. Okay, you're gonna have to keep holding. Doing that there. You can use take that off in the end anyways.
There's something wrong here. Oh, it's a nail.
Yeah, that's the nail out. Doesn't have a sheet, but has a look.
Yeah, I don't have any with sheets at the moment. At least we can start fixing it, you know?
Yeah.
And it's the first one in to start fixing.
Okay. What's the smoke?
Sure, okay, so we didn't get right into the bottom of the last brood box. Because the gent that donated these to us, bless him, he was putting 9 frames in, so the frames are all a bit of a mess. So what we're going to do is we'll do multiple inspections on this colony, and we'll start feeding in brand new frames so that they can rebuild them out and try and clean up the mess that's inside here. It's going to take some time, but if you follow me on the channel, click subscribe, then you know, we'll keep you up to date on this hive. And look, it's a producing colony, so we've got a whole lot of honey out of it. We've given them some honey back, we haven't taken everything. And then we've just reduced that brood box at the bottom down, because there wasn't anything in the second brood box, to be honest with you. It was actually more honey. So this will be a little safer on the stand. I was a bit worried with the storms that this was going to fall over, but I think that'll work out okay. Anything you want to say?
Yeah, I mean, 3 years
we opened that hive. I don't know what we were supposed to expect, but look, it's a bit of a mess. The guy only put 9 frames in a 10 frame hive, so the frames are skew, the bees have built all over the place. Hey, we've just got our job cut out for us, so anyway, that's beekeeping. We'll work this one right, and then we've got a nice honey producing colony right now. So it's fantastic.
Cool.
Hope you enjoyed this episode. Hit that like button if you did.
Remember to subscribe if you like our content.
Yeah, I already said that.
Okay. Till next time, eh?